The Sea Shepherd set a course for port, planning to dock in the Tasmanian capital, Hobart. They have 4,500 kilometers to travel and barely enough fuel to get there.
The last few days we've been a little bit concerned about the amount of fuel we have available to get us back to Hobart.
Where are we at now? 40, 41, is it?
Well, in that chart, we've got 5 days, 5 days, 11 hours, so let's call it 6 days. Mm. 6 days at 6.25. Right, it's 37.5. That gives us a margin of about five tons.
God.
Which we were told was too little.
The repercussions of running out of fuel are really big. If we run out of fuel, we need to call on another ship to help us. It's going to cost us money, and it's also going to make us look like we don't have a clue what's going on.
So, completely dependent on the weather between here and Hobart. Mm.
Well, if I could forecast what the seas were going to be, I'd be a very rich man.
Rough weather usually means you should be cutting back on the power, because all you're doing is banging the ship around, sometimes hurting it.
Yeah, it'll be a close thing for fuel. And that's provided the weather stays as good as it is. It looks like it won't.
We just tied down some of the straps on the boats because they come loose. Pretty wild out here.
A huge low-pressure system blows in, increasing the demand on the ship's already low fuel reserves.
Whenever you get sideways into waves that size and you're lightweight like we are with no fuel and water, you can get knocked over.
It's pretty serious.
Yeah, it was a rocky old ride. Yeah, we were getting thrown around quite violently, so it's pretty scary stuff.
At this rate, we'll pretty much not make it to Hobart. Fuel's pretty tight. We could roll into Hobart with just on fumes.
Our cabins are going up and down by 15, 20 feet. Feels like being on a roller coaster. And I hate roller coasters.
I'm hoping the seas will calm down soon. Please calm down.
The rough seas take a toll on the Steve Irwin and its crew.
Keep my head on the ground.
In the chaos of the storm, Zin Rain, the second cook, slipped on the wet floor and hit her head.
And then I sat up and I heard you say you're bleeding.
I reckon that we should go back down to the mess.
You need to be able to lie down while I sew it up.
As a medical officer, I need to be prepared to deal with whatever it is that happens.
This is Merrin's first time suturing a wound at sea, and she needs a particularly steady hand during the storm. The procedure is a success, leaving Zin to rest and heal through the remaining rough seas. Finally, the storm subsides.
The swell's died down a bit. We've gone from what was maybe 8 meters yesterday to what is now maybe 4 or 5.
Yeah, how accurate's the weather today? Is it blowing 20 knots where we are?
Yeah, right now we should have 20 knot winds.
Well, it's pretty close. We have 40 knot winds, so that's 100% off at the moment.
100%.
That's been almost 100% incorrect on a daily basis.
Well, what's our speed? We're going directly into the wind, so you add our speed to it. That's 32 and a half knots.
Okay, it's 50% off.
During Peter Brown's shifts, there's just complete lack of any sort of a team environment.
Looks like it's steady about 35 knots.
Well, you haven't been watching very much then, but whatever.
Seems pretty close.
It's amazing how one person like that can just really spoil all the efforts of so many great, competent volunteers.
The Sea Shepherds are nearing the end of the first leg of their campaign. Peter poses a question to the crew.
Let me know if you're thinking of leaving the ship before the second leg so that we might have to find other crew, but hopefully you'll all stay, because this is, without a doubt, and you know, Paul would agree, this is the best crew we've had in a long, long, long time. So I hope you leave this ship with a feeling of a tremendous amount of pride that you did absolutely everything you could to save as many whales as you could. I think the engagement went really well, and we've scattered the whalers to the four winds, and we're chasing them now. They're certainly not killing any whales, and that's where we need to be as an organization. So I just want to finish off by saying a huge thank you to everyone for their hard work and for all of you staying. Let's go back and get them. That's all I have to say. Thank you.